Welcome to This Week in Costa Rica. Thanks for joining us again this week. Always appreciate it. info@thisweekincostarica.com is the email address. Head on over to the website if you like as well. You'll find all the show notes and links to everything we talk about here today, including links over to the Facebook and the Twitter. YouTube clips now as well, trying to make my guests as uncomfortable as possible by turning on all these studio lights and getting them on camera. First guest today is David Carr from right here in Hakoa. How are you, David?
I'm good.
God, it's nice to see your face.
Yeah, it's good to be here.
You've been on the show before, but I think this is the first time you've actually come into studio and visited me here.
Yeah, now I have the bright lights, so feeling the heat.
Yeah, how'd you like the makeup session?
It was good.
Pretty nice. Yeah. We are rolling up into Semana Santa here. For a lot of the people up in the United States, of course, we just call it Easter. But as you know, here in Costa Rica and throughout Latin America, Semana Santa is just huge. Just an entire week affair. Things close down. People flock to the beaches. And this town goes berserk.
Yeah, it's crazy. And it's already starting. I had some friends on Facebook post some pictures and the traffic's already kicking in.
How do you go about it? Do you go out there, hit the beach, and you get involved in it? Or do you like to lock yourself in the condo? Like
I'm one of those that locks myself in. You know, okay. Being a local guy, we have everything here all the time. And maybe go out, grab something to eat. But for the most part, I'm kind of staying in.
Incredible for business, though. This is the last big boom of the high season for a lot of people. Yep. And it's the opportunity for a lot of the restaurants and the hoteliers and the condo rentals to make big, big money.
Yep. No, and it's great for the community. I mean, this time we actually have Haco Extremo, which is a big 10K race, kind of kicking off that Semana Santa. So it's going to be a real busy next couple, about 10 days or so.
Yeah, I was out in the street just recently and I saw a bunch of people wearing their Haco Extremo jerseys and ready to go. And this is a big run. I don't know if I could run 10K though in this heat.
Yeah, forget that. I wouldn't run it in regular temperatures, right. You know, let alone this heat. So.
But they finish it here on the beach, don't they?
Yep.
Yeah, so it's pretty amazing. When I remember, I think it was last year that I was here. And I didn't even know what was going on. Yeah. So I went down to the beach for a swim and I was cut off by like 2,000 people who were running across the beach. It was phenomenal.
Yeah. No, it's a great turnout. It seems like it's getting busier and more popular every year. So.
Right.
Big group.
You know, one of the things I don't understand, and this is maybe just the gringo bitching, but it never made sense to me that during Semana Santa, there is that kind of dry law where you can't go out and you can't buy liquor. But I think there's still sort of ways you can do that around here. Like I remember when I lived in Santana, you know, in the San Jose area, there was always a secret knock on somebody's door that you could go and buy liquor. But I mean, here in Haco, in a beach community like this, where everyone's flocking to the beach, do you think that everyone's going to go ahead and abide by that law? Or do you think there are opportunities for people to get liquor?
I doubt that. You know, I'm pretty sure that there's access to it. I think a lot of people stock up and get it beforehand. So,
but it doesn't make a lot of sense to me because it's the same thing. You remember the elections happened this year on the day of the Super Bowl. So if I'm running a restaurant or a bar and, you know, I've got all my big screens on and it's full of people, technically and legally, I'm not allowed to sell liquor because there's an election going on.
Yeah. I think in Haco, things are a little bit more laid back too, so maybe people kind of turn the other way.
But, right.
But yeah, you know, and especially this week, we get a lot of families, a lot of people with, you know, the Catholics. We're getting a lot of people that aren't necessarily drinking anyway.
Sure, so, yeah. Sure. Now, to get all this information, of course, I found, of course, your site is one of the best, I think, out there. And you've got Visit Haco right now. Yep. What's the URL for that?
It's visithacocostarica.com.
Okay.
And yeah, it has a lot of travel tips because exactly that. There's a lot of people that are planning their spring break, a vacation down here, and they don't realize how busy it is during Semana Santa. And you definitely have to account for that, especially once you're coming from the airport or going back. I mean, there's definitely going to be traffic. Accommodations are going to be higher priced, more hard to find. So a lot of travel tips just like that on the site.
You are not talking about special occasions. The more I think in the past, in the last 8 years I've been living here, almost every Semana Santa, I have visitors coming down from Canada or the U.S. to spend time with me.
Sure.
And they send me their travel dates and their plane tickets and everything. And they're like, do you think we'll have a hard time getting a hotel? It's like, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the worst time of year to travel.
Worst time. And it's such a swing because if they can just wait maybe a week after.
Sure.
A lot of times the rates will turn around and go off peak. So it's a big swing. I mean, you're going from one of the highest to possibly, you know, a low off-season rate in that quick of a span.
No, absolutely. And of course, availability is another consideration as well.
For sure.
Because everyone who comes down at this time of year, I mean, they want to do tours and they want to do all that stuff. And not only that, but a lot of the tour companies have limited amounts of tours available because most of their staff is, guess what, on vacation for Semana Santa.
Exactly. Yeah.
Yeah. So what else you got on this site over here?
So really, I made the site for just people planning their vacation to Hako. I mean, there's a really shortage of information when it comes to planning in a trip to Hako, Costa Rica. Mm-hmm. So it's a basic info and tourism site, a lot of good pictures, good information, and more of the local information, right? Yeah. I mean, where do the locals go to eat? Where do the locals go for the beaches and activities and things like that? So obviously, it's got the tourist attractions, but it's a lot of good information for anyone planning a trip down.
Yeah, you know, it's funny because now you and I are both locals here. We know all the tips and the tricks and everything, but it almost pains me when I have people come even from like Santa Ana or San Jose to visit, and they say, hey, let's go to Taco Bar. It's the place to go, right? It's like, yeah, Taco Bar is good. Mm-hmm. And, you know, you also have one in Escazú, and you've got one over there in Santa Ana or whatever, but you know, as you and I, it's like we need some sort of exposure to some of these really great places, these little hidden gems here.
Sure.
That many people never think about.
Sure. And just more information. I mean, I think the stop for most people is TripAdvisor, but TripAdvisor doesn't always get it right.
Sure.
I mean, they're a little skewed. And even on the site now, I mean, some of their pictures are just terrible and mm-hmm. people want to see. I mean, a lot of times people just don't even know what the beach looks like in Hako.
Yeah.
You know, or what's town look like. So it has all that good information and definitely a perfect spot for people planning.
You know, I'm friends with a lot of journalists and a lot of travel writers. And you happen to get to know these people in the business. And it's interesting because almost every time without exception, when one of these journalists or travel writers come and visit me for a period of time, they come with the preconceived notion about what Hako is, mm-hmm. you know? And again, this is the stigma that is so hard to wash off. Because of the years and years and years of difficulties Hako had experienced. But now we're seeing this sort of turning point, I think, in the last 4 or 5 years, where it's becoming more family friendly. It's okay. Becoming more secure. Prostitution and drugs are not as, you know, prolific as they once were on the street. Yep. They're being very isolated to certain areas now. Yep. And well controlled. The police presence is incredible. I could go on and on and on. Mm-hmm. And the point being is that a lot of these journalists come in and they immediately write about how Hako is and what they thought it was, mm-hmm. you know, and are you finding as well that in your area that you're getting the same kind of feedback from people?
Yeah, absolutely. And just doing a lot of research with the site and looking at reviews, I mean, you see it, the reviews, I mean, it's changed. I mean, you're getting a lot of positive reviews and you get a lot of people that say, oh, I heard it was this, but I experienced this, you know, it was a great thing. So, Hako, I think is definitely, like you said, it's turning right now and we're seeing a lot of good feedback.
That's great. All right. Well, I'll tell you what, I'm going to put the URL to visithakocostarica.com yep. up on our website so people can check that out. And as well, I'll put a link over to your, I think you got a real estate set going as well if people want to get a hold of you.
Absolutely. DavidCarProperties.com and they can get to me as far as questions on real estate, consulting, or rentals as well.
That's perfect. I'm going to not look for you on the street during Semana Santa because I know we're both going to be holed up. But thanks so much for coming in today.
My pleasure.
All right, stick around, guys. We've got Dan Stevens from the Costa Rican Times coming up next. And, of course, a great interview with author Shannon Annette on This Week in Costa Rica, only on the Overseas Radio Network.
So you want to jump out your trick bag and ease on into your bag, but you ain't just exactly sure what.